Welcome to Insane Curiosity. Do you think there could be life somewhere in the universe? I mean, life as we know it, maybe on another planet. It could exist in a galaxy far, far away, or maybe on a planet around a star in our own galaxy, the Milky Way. Wouldn't it be nice, though, if one day we discovered that life was hiding much closer than we thought, maybe in our own solar system? This is actually not impossible. It could be plausible to find life as we know it in our solar system. The only question is, where? Keep watching the video to understand why a Saturn moon called Mimas could be the right target. Usually when we think about life in our solar system, we think about Mars. This is because in the past, Mars was actually not so different from Earth. From what we know, it hosted oceans of liquid water. It had a noticeable magnetic field and an atmosphere. All of these things put together could have contributed to building a nice environment that could support life. Perseverance rover will use its instruments to look for signs of ancient life in the delta and lake deposits in the so-called Jezero crater, and will hopefully allow us to finally answer the question of whether there was ever life on Mars. In addition, Perseverance will begin the process of collecting samples that could one day be returned to Earth. Once returned to Earth by a future mission, these Mars samples can be subjected to more detailed analysis by a much wider set of instruments than can be carried by Perseverance. Moreover, sample archiving can preserve material for future analysis here on Earth and new and/or more detailed instruments that may not yet exist. So even if Perseverance does not find evidence of past life, it will collect samples that, once returned to Earth, could provide new insight into the evolution of Mars and whether there was ever life on the red planet. So we are already working on Mars, but this doesn't mean that we should only focus on this planet. Could there be some other places where to look at? In some of our past videos, we discussed the possibility for some of Saturn or Jupiter's moons to host life. For example, Enceladus and Europa are all covered by ice, as it is quite evident if you look at these pictures taken by spacecraft some years ago. If you look carefully, for example, you can notice some sort of rivers covering the whole surface of Europa on the left side. Europa's vast and unfathomably deep ocean is widely considered the most promising place to look for life beyond Earth. A passing spacecraft might even be able to sample Europa's ocean without landing on the moon's surface, because it is possible that Europa's ocean may be leaking out into space. Conjectures regarding extraterrestrial life have ensured a high profile for Europa and have led to steady lobbying for future missions, so I think we will hear some news soon coming from this distant moon. In particular, we will have Jupiter Icy Moon Explorer, JUICE, which will include two flybys of Europa. Another important mission in the program is Europa Clipper. It aims to explore Europa to investigate its habitability and select sites for a future lander. Imagine how amazing it would be to find that there's life on a moon in the solar system. Anyway, in this video, we want to talk about a new study, which could turn out to be really interesting for what concerns the finding of life in our solar system. Let's see what astronomers found. Let's begin by looking at Mimas a little closer. Here it is, a small, pretty sphere orbiting around Saturn. The big crater on the right side, it's huge. Its diameter's extension is something like 1/3 of the diameter of the moon. It's called the Herschel crater. It was named in honor of the astronomer William Herschel, who discovered Mimas and Enceladus in 1789. On September 17th of that year, the astronomer pointed his telescope in the direction of Saturn and discovered Mimas. The small satellite, just 396 kilometers across, is the 7th of Saturn and the 21st of the solar system in size. Mimas is also the smallest celestial body known to have a spherical shape due to its gravitational field. Its diameter is approximately 140 kilometers. Its walls are approximately 5 kilometers high, and parts of its bottom reach a depth of 10 kilometers, and the relief in the center rises 6 kilometers over the surrounding land. Proportionately, a similar crater on Earth would be over 4,000 kilometers across and larger than Canada. The impact from which Herschel originated must have nearly disintegrated Mimas. On the opposite side of the satellite, there are in fact evident fractures that could be due to the shock wave of the impact. The fun fact is that Herschel crater's presence makes Mimas curiously similar to the Death Star from Star Wars, the weapon through which the Empire perpetrated its regime of terror, capable of destroying entire planets. a regime, the one established by the Empire, destined to be overwhelmed by a revolution as in France only a few years after the successful discovery of Herschel. However, this is mere coincidence, as the crater was discovered several years after the film was made. But what does this have to do with water and life as we know it? Well, apparently nothing. If you take a look at Mimas and then you take a look at Enceladus, for example, you will notice that they are completely different. In fact, Mimas doesn't seem to host an ocean of liquid water, while on Enceladus we can clearly see signatures of moving pieces of ice frost on the surface, which means they are moving on a liquid water ocean. Mimas doesn't show the same characteristics. That's why at first sight, astronomers soon discarded the possibility for Mimas to host life. It was simply not the right place. But then when the Cassini probe sent data from Saturn in 2014, the game changed. NASA's mission, which orbited and studied Saturn for over a decade, detected an unexpected oscillation in Mimas's rotation. As it spins on its axis, Mimas wobbles slightly, an effect called libration. That was something to be explained. Why was it happening? Before finding out the answer to the question, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can continue to improve and make these videos better for you, the viewer. Plus, be sure to subscribe to the channel by clicking the bell so that you don't miss any of our weekly videos. Someone suggested that this could be due to the shape of Mimas' nucleus. A very elongated nucleus could cause the observed libration movement. Does Mimas have such an elongated nucleus? Well, the same huge impact which created the Herschel crater might have led to a stretching of the layers at the nucleus level. So maybe we can consider this option. But what observations say is that other moons which have experienced huge impacts in the past don't show such an important libration movement. So maybe there is something more to be studied in detail. After 3 years of continuous observations, astronomers decided that Mimas was geologically inactive and therefore no oceans could be found on its surface. They simulated what's going on in the interior of the moon, and they tried to reproduce the same surface we observe by imposing the existence of an ocean at the same time. Needless to say, all the simulations gave the same answer. No ocean configuration can lead to the observed surface. But we all know that the technology improves as years go on, and simulations get more and more accurate. The power of new computers is astonishing, and they can predict behaviors in a really precise way. So in January of 2022, a team of astronomers gave another try to simulations and found that some configurations exist that produce both a liquid ocean and the observed surface. If Mimas has an ocean, it represents a new class of small, stealth ocean worlds with surfaces that do not betray the ocean's existence. Alyssa Roden, a geophysicist who led the analysis at the Southwestern Research Institute, said in a press release. Of course, it's still no guarantee of a secret Mimas ocean. Researchers need to investigate the moon for further evidence. The work doesn't prove that there is a subsurface ocean on Mimas, but it does show that an ocean is perfectly consistent with the available data and our understanding of the physics, and the authors are appropriately cautious about this. If Mimas has water, it will become the third of Saturn's 82 moons known to contain underground oceans. This result could be really interesting because it would imply that we could have life even in places where we didn't expect it to be. In short, we are not able to tell which moons in the outer solar system may have subsurface oceans just from their surface geology. As you can see, the universe always surprises us with its creativity. Who knows, maybe we will find life on some exoplanets, or maybe we will first find it in our solar system. And maybe we will find it on a planet or a moon. Who knows? Of course, everything is possible. There is also another creepy option. We could be completely alone in the universe. Maybe we are the exception. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching, everyone. Do you think we will ever find life on another moon or planet? Did you know about the existence of Mimas? Let us know in the comments below. Be sure to subscribe, and we'll see you next time on the channel.